Sarum students, welcome. Today let us do the revision of history lesson number 5, Kingdoms, Kings and an Early Republic. Children, in this lesson we shall revise about how some men became rulers and about Varnas, Janapadas and Mahajanapadas. And we shall also revise about taxes and changes in agriculture and a closer look, that is about Magadha and Vajji. And we shall also revise about Ajatasattu and the Vajjis and elsewhere, that is about Greece and Athens. So children, today let us revise about how some men became rulers and about Varnas and Janapadas. Now children, let us read about election day. Shankaran, he woke up to see his grandparents and they are all ready to go and vote, and they wanted to be the first to reach the polling booth. Why? Shankaran, he wanted to know. Were they so excited? Somewhat impatiently, his grandfather, he explained that we can choose our own rulers today. That is, choosing leaders or rulers by voting is something that has become common during the last 50 years or so. Now let us revise the first topic, that is how some men became rulers. Children, how did men become rulers in the past? Some of the rajas, they were probably chosen by the jana, that means by the people. But around 3000 years ago, we find some changes that were taking place in the ways in which rajas were chosen, and some men, they now became recognized as rajas by performing very big sacrifices. Children, can you name a ritual that was used to recognize someone as a raja? Ashwamedha was one ritual used to recognize kings. So the Ashwamedha or horse sacrifice was one such ritual. That is, a horse, it was let loose to wander freely and it was guarded by the Raja's men. And if the horse, it wandered into the kingdoms of other Rajas, and if they stopped it, that means they had to fight with the Raja who is going to perform the Ashwamedha Yajna. And if they allowed the horse to pass, that means it meant that they had accepted that the Raja who wanted to perform the Ashwamedha Yajna, that is the sacrifice, he was stronger than them. And then these Rajas, they were invited to the sacrifice, which was performed by specially trained priests and who were rewarded with gifts. This means the Raja who organized the sacrifice, he was recognized as being very powerful, and all those who came there, they brought gifts for him. And the Raja, he was a central figure in these rituals. And where did he sit? He often had a special seat, that is a throne or a tiger skin, and his charioteer, who was his companion in the battlefield and who had witnessed his exploits. He often chanted tales of the king's glory. And who had to perform a variety of minor rituals? His relatives, especially his wives and sons, they had to perform a variety of minor rituals. And the other Rajas, they were simply spectators. That is, they just had to sit and watch the performance of the sacrifice. And who performed the rituals? Priests, they performed the rituals, including the sprinkling of sacred water on the king. And who brought gifts for the king? The ordinary people, the Vish or Vaishya, they also brought gifts for the kings. But however, some people, such as those who were regarded as Shudras by the priests, they were excluded from many rituals. Children, how many Vedas are there? There are 4 of them. Can you name them? Rigveda, Samaveda, Yajurveda and Atharvaveda. Now children, let us revise about Varnas. We have many books that were composed in North India, especially in the areas that were drained by the Ganga and the Yamuna rivers during this period. And these books, what are they called? They are often called as later Vedic. Why? Because they were composed after the Rig Veda. Can you name the books that were called as later Vedic? These include the Samaveda, Yajurveda and Atharva Veda, as well as other books. And who composed them? These were composed by priests, and they also described how rituals were to be performed, and they also contained rules about society. And children, there were several different groups in society at that time, that is the priests and warriors, farmers, herders, traders, craftspersons, laborers, fishing folk and forest people. And can you tell what does Varna mean? The priests, they divided people into four groups called Varnas, and according to them, each Varna had a different set of functions. Children, can you name the four groups into which later Vedic society was divided? It was divided into Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and Shudras. Now let us revise about the different set of functions performed by each Varna. Which was the first Varna? The first Varna was that of the Brahmin. And what were they expected to do? Brahmins were expected to study and teach Vedas and perform sacrifices and receive gifts. And in the second place were the rulers. And what were they known as? They are also known as Kshatriyas. And what were they expected to do? They were expected to fight battles and protect people. And third were the Vish or the Vaishyas. And they were expected to be farmers, herders and traders. And who could perform sacrifices? Both the Kshatriyas and the Vaishyas. They could perform sacrifices. And who were the last? Last were the Shudras. And what they had to do? They had to serve the other three groups, that is the Brahmins, Kshatriyas and Vaishyas, and they could not perform any rituals. And often women, they were also grouped with the Shudras. So both women and Shudras, they were not allowed to study the Vedas. And the priests, they also said that these groups, they were decided on the basis of birth. And here we can see an example, that is, if one's father and mother were Brahmins, then one would automatically become a Brahmin, and so on. Later, the priests, they classified some people as untouchable. Whom did they include as untouchable? These included some craftspersons, hunters and gatherers, as well as people who helped perform burials and cremations. And the priests, they said that the contact with these groups, it was polluting. And many people, they did not accept the system of Varna that was laid down by the Brahmins. That is, some kings, they thought that they were superior to the priests. And others, they felt that birth, it could not be a basis for deciding which Varna people belong to. Besides, some people, they felt that there should be no differences amongst people based on occupation. And others, they felt that everybody should be able to perform rituals. And others, they condemned the practice of untouchability. And also, there were many areas in the subcontinent, such as the Northeast, where the social and economic differences were not very sharp and where the influence of the priests was limited. Now children, let us revise the next topic, that is about Janapadas, the Rajas who performed these big sacrifices, that is the Ashwamedha Yajna. They were now recognized as being Rajas of Janapadas rather than Janas. And children, what does the word Janapada mean? The word Janapada, it literally means the land where the jana means people, set its foot and settled down. And children, archaeologists, they have excavated a number of settlements in these janapadas, that is Purana Killa in Delhi and Hastinapura near Meerut and Atranji Khera near Etta. The last two, that is Hastinapura and Atranji Khera, they are in Uttar Pradesh. And they found that people lived in huts and they kept cattle as well as other animals. And they also grew a variety of crops such as rice, wheat, barley, pulses, sugarcane, sesame and mustard. And they made earthen pots. And what was the color of these pots? Some of these were grey in color and others were red. And there was one special type of pottery that was found at these sites. And what is it known as? It is known as painted grey ware. And what did these grey pots have? These grey pots, they had painted designs, usually simple lines and geometric patterns. Now children, let us revise more about painted grey ware. What are the most common vessels that were made out of painted grey ware? Plates and bowls, they are the most common vessels that were made out of painted grey ware. And these are extremely fine to touch with a nice smooth surface. And perhaps these were used on special occasions for important people and to serve special food. Children, here you can see an image of the painted grey ware. Now children, let's discuss. Write a short note on the Ashwamedha ritual. The Ashwamedha, that is the horse sacrifice. It was a ritual used to recognize men as rajas. And a horse, it was left to wander freely. And if it wandered into another kingdom and the king of that kingdom stopped it, then they had to fight. And the raja who succeeded in the challenge, he was recognized as stronger. And he would then perform the sacrifice in which other kings would also come. And what is known about the Janapadas and their people? The word Janapada, it literally means the land where the Jana set its foot and settled down. And archaeologists, they have excavated a number of settlements in Janapadas. They have found that people lived in huts and the people kept cattle as well as other animals. And they grew a variety of crops like rice, wheat, barley, pulses, sugarcane, sesame and mustard. And they made earthen pots, some of which were grey in colour and some red. So children, today we have done part 1 revision of history lesson number 5, Kingdoms, Kings and an Early Republic. We shall continue with the revision of this lesson in our next class. Till we meet again, goodbye children.